English Fairy Tales by Flora Annie Steel. The Old Woman and Her Pig. An old woman was sweeping her house, and she found a little crooked sixpence. "What," said she, "shall I do with this little sixpence? I will go to market and buy a little pig." So she brought a little pig, but as she was coming home she came to a stile, and the piggy would not go over the stile. She went a little further, and she met a dog. So she said to him, "Dog, dog, bite pig. Piggy won't go over the stile, and I shan't get home till midnight." But the dog wouldn't. She went a little further, and she met a stick. So she said, "Stick, stick, beat dog. Dog won't bite pig. Piggy won't get over the stile, and I shan't get home till midnight." But the stick wouldn't. She went a little further, and she met a fire. So she said, "Fire, fire, burn stick. Stick won't beat dog. Dog won't bite pig. Pig won't get over the stile, and I shan't get home till midnight." But the fire wouldn't. She went a little further, and she met some water. So she said, "Water, water, quench fire. Fire won't burn stick. Stick won't beat dog. Dog won't bite pig. Pig won't get over the stile, and I shan't get home till midnight." But the water wouldn't. She went a little further, and she met an ox. So she said, "Ox, ox, drink water. Water won't quench fire. Fire won't burn stick. Stick won't beat dog. Dog won't bite pig. Pig won't get over the stile, and I shan't get home till midnight." But the ox wouldn't. She went a little further, and she met a butcher. So she said, "Butcher, butcher, kill ox. Ox won't drink water. Water won't quench fire. Fire won't burn stick. Stick won't beat dog. Dog won't bite pig. Pig won't get over the stile, and I shan't get home till midnight." But the butcher wouldn't. She went a little further, and she met a rope. So she said, "Rope, rope, hang butcher. Butcher won't kill ox. Ox won't drink water. Water won't quench fire. Fire won't burn stick. Stick won't beat dog. Dog won't bite pig. Pig won't get over the stile, and I shan't get home till midnight." But the rope wouldn't. She went a little further, and she met a rat. So she said, "Rat, rat, gnaw rope. Rope won't hang butcher. Butcher won't kill ox. Ox won't drink water. Water won't quench fire. Fire won't burn stick. Stick won't beat dog. Dog won't bite pig. Pig won't get over the stile, and I shan't get home till midnight." But the rat wouldn't. She went a little further, and she met a cat. So she said, "Cat, cat, kill rat. Rat won't gnaw rope. Rope won't hang butcher. Butcher won't kill ox. Ox won't drink water. Water won't quench fire. Fire won't burn stick. Stick won't beat dog. Dog won't bite pig. Pig won't get over the stile, and I shan't get home to midnight." But the cat said to her, "If you will go to yonder cow and fetch me a saucer of milk, I will kill the rat." So away went the old woman to the cow. But the cow said to her, "If you will go to yonder haystack and fetch me a handful of hay, I'll give you the milk." So away went the old woman to the haystack, and she brought the hay to the cow. As soon as the cow had eaten the hay, she gave the old woman the milk, and away she went with it in a saucer to the cat. As soon as the cat had lapped up the milk, the cat began to kill the rat. The rat began to gnaw the rope. The rope began to hang the butcher. The butcher began to kill the ox. The ox began to drink the water. The water began to quench the fire. The fire began to burn the stick. The stick began to beat the dog. The dog began to bite the pig. The little pig squealed and jumped over the stile. And so the old woman got home before midnight. End of chapter 26. Recording by Linda Marie Nielsen, Vancouver, BC.